Hi children, today we are going to discuss the series and parallel combination of capacitors. First we will discuss series combination of capacitors. So it is similar to the series combination of resistors and parallel combination of resistors which you had studied in your 10th standard. This is series combination of capacitors. So the symbol for capacitor is this, means draw two parallel lines like this. One will act as positive plate, another will act as negative plate after getting charged. Now I have taken three capacitors and I connected them like this as second plate of the first capacitor C1 is connected to the first plate of the second capacitor C2. Second plate of the second capacitor is connected to first plate of the third capacitor C3, like that. Now this combination is said to be in series. So here we connect a battery across it. This is the battery connected, positive and negative. The potential difference of the battery is V, means where battery is supplying V volts, battery is supplying V volts potential difference. When it is connected to positive, this end is positive, this plate becomes positive and this plate becomes negative. In series combination, what happens? If this is positive, negative will appear and positive will appear and negative and positive, like this. In series combination, they are said to be in series combination. The capacitors are said to be in series combination if same charge appears on the plates. Same charge. When coming to the charge on the capacitor plates, very important point which I am going to stress now. Charge on the capacitor refers to charge on its positive plate, because there is a misconception that positive plate is having plus Q charge, negative plate is having minus Q charge, so the net charge on the capacitor is zero. This is not correct. Capacitor is a device used to store charge, of course. It doesn't mean that the sum of the charges on the two plates is equal to zero. So charge on the capacitor refers to the charge on its positive plate only. Now these three capacitors are connected in series. So in series combination, negative plate of first is connected to positive of the second, negative of the second is connected to positive of the first, like that. Then such combination is known as series combination. Their capacities are different, but charge on each plate is same. Charge on each plate is same. Now we are going to use relation like Q equal to CV. Okay. Q equal to CV. Q is charge, C is capacity, V is potential. Since charge on each plate is same, capacities are different, potentials will be different. That means, suppose I write for first capacitor Q equal to, I can write C1 into V1. Okay. So what is V1? V1 equal to Q by C1. Sum of the potentials V1, V2, V3 must be equal to this applied potential V. Okay, so in series combination, let the capacities be C1, C2, C3, then potentials become equal to V1 equal to Q by C1. Similarly, V2 equal to Q by C2. V3 equal to Q upon C3. Right? Now, as the applied potential, battery potential, is equal to sum of the three potentials, V1 plus V2 plus V3, I can take V as Q by C effective, means CS. S stands for series combination. C is capacity, S stands for series. Why I have taken same Q here? Because same charge flows through the three plates, same charge flows through the circuit, same charge appears on each plate. Same charge appears on each plate. So here the charge is Q and battery is also supplying the same charge Q. Q by CS is equal to Q by C1 plus Q by C2 plus Q by C3. You can cancel Q by taking it common. So you will get the effective capacity as 1 by CS equal to 1 by C1 plus 1 by C2 plus 1 by C3. So reciprocal of effective capacity is equal to sum of the reciprocals of the individual capacities. So what is meant by series combination? Whenever you see an arrangement appearing like this, you can call it as series combination. In series combination, you should know that negative of first plate is connected to positive of second, negative of second is connected to positive of first, like that. Such a combination is known as series combination. Okay. Now, what are the important points that we can take as inference here? First one is, in series combination, charge on each capacitor is same. That means if you want to take the charge ratio on the plates of each capacitor, the charge ratio of charges is 1:1:1. Number two, in series combination, potentials are different. So if I write the ratio of potentials, V1 is to V2 is to V3, V1 is Q by C1, V2 is Q by C2, V3 is Q by C3, Q gets cancelled if you take the ratio, you will get the potentials ratio as 1 by C1 is to 1 by C2 is to 1 by C3. Number 3, if two capacitors C1 and C2 are in series, then 1 by CS is equal to 1 by C1 plus 1 by C2. I take LCM like this, you will get C1 plus C2 by C1 C2. Don't forget to take the reciprocal, CS equal to C1 C2 by C1 plus C2. So simple. So when there are two capacitors, directly go for this formula. You don't go for this 1 by C1 plus 1 by C2 and then taking LCM, directly you can do it. Okay. Next point is, if two capacitors each of capacity C are connected in series, means there are two capacitors C and C, they are connected in series. In such case, what is the effective capacity? Effective capacity, actual formula is 1 by C plus 1 by C. If you follow this, you will get 2 by C. So C effective becomes C by 2. Very simple. That means there are two capacitors connected in series, which are having capacities 4 microfarad and 4 microfarad. The effective capacity of the combination is 4 by 2, 2 microfarad. Such an easy talk, easy concept. Next, if three capacitors of capacity C each are connected in series, then it becomes C by 3. Okay. For clarification, you can see this 1 by C effective equal to 1 by C plus 1 by C plus 1 by C equals to 3 by C. C effective equal to C by 3. So now, if you take n capacitors of capacity C each are connected in series, then it becomes 1 by C effective equal to 1 by C plus 1 by C plus and so on, 1 by C, how many times? N times. So when there are 2, you will get 2 by C. When there are 3, you are getting 3 by C. If there are N, you will get N by C. Therefore, C effective equal to C by N. Very simple. Next, if two capacitors are connected in series like this, C1 and C2. Of course, we know that same charge appears on the plates, plus Q minus Q plus Q minus Q. The potential difference across the battery is V. The question is, what are the potential differences between C1 and C2? Suppose I am getting 20 volt here, how much potential I get here, how much potential I get here, because potential gets divided. In the second point, I told you that potential ratio is 1 by C1 is to 1 by C2. That means it is equal to C2 is to C1. So V1 is to V2 is equal to C2 is to C1. Very simple. So if you want V1, then what we have to do, the ratio means its fraction is C2 only, C2 by C1 plus C2 into total voltage V. If it is not clear, I do like this. Okay, V1 by V2 is C2 by C1. You want V1, so I take the reciprocal of this fraction. V2 by V1 is equal to C1 by C2. Now what I have to do, add 1 on both sides to this fraction. Okay, I'll do here. What I am getting, V2 plus V1, V2 plus V1 by V1 is equal to C1 plus C2 by C2. So V1 equal to C2 by C1 plus C2 into V2 plus V1. The sum of these two is equal to this, which is equal to V. So V1 equal to VC2 by C1 plus C2. V2 equal to, similarly I can write VC1 by C1 plus C2. I hope you understood this. Now, if I gave one small numerical like this, 3 microfarad and 6 microfarad, two capacitors are connected across a battery of supply 12 volt. What is the effective capacity of this? When there are two capacitors, as I told you, the formula is C1 C2 by C1 plus C2, 3 into 6 by 3 plus 6, 18 by 9, which is equal to 2. From this, we can conclude one important point. C effective is always less than the least of the combining capacitors, less than the least of the individual capacities, like that also you can write individual capacities. See, 3 and 6 are connected in series, you will get the effective capacity less than the least of the two. Which is the least of the two? 3. So you will get effective capacity as 2, which is less than even 3. That's very important. Now V1, how do we get V1? V1, the formula is VC2 by C1 plus C2. As I told you, this is V1, this is V2, this is C1, this is C2, and this is V. What is the value of V? 12, C2, 6, 3 plus 6, okay, 12 into 6 by 9, 3, 4 times, 18 by 4, 9 by 2, you will get 4.5 volt. V2 means out of 12, 4.5 drops across C1. The remaining is 12 minus 4.5. You will get 7.5 volt will be dropped across C2. So this is about series combination of capacitors, children.